Welcome to the video news of the week. News has been dominated this week by the disappearance of an 11-year-old girl from West Stewartstown. The search for Celina Cass has received national attention as police and FBI forces continue to look for the girl. According to the police, Celina Cass, who is 5'5" tall, weighs 95 pounds, and has hazel eyes and waist-length brown hair, was wearing a pink shirt, a pink pullover, blue shorts and shoes when her parents last saw her at their Washington Street home at 9 p.m. on Monday night. A search has been underway near Celina's home with state police, New Hampshire Fish and Game, several canine units, the U.S. Border Patrol, and local police assisting. Celina's family and friends have distributed posters with her photograph and description and handed them out to businesses throughout the North Country in an effort to find the missing youth. We spoke with one family who were helping search for the missing girl along Route 3, just north of the village.
We got posters brought to us. We're going to walk to the store, so we figured while we were walking, we'd look down through here, since I don't think anyone's been through here yet. So last we heard, she was on the computer when her mother went to bed. I guess this morning she was not home, and she's 11 years old. She's never left the house before without her mom and her sister. You know, so I don't understand why she'd just take off and leave in the middle of the night. You know, not letting anyone know where she's at or anything.
At 9 p.m., about 50 residents were led in a candlelight vigil in the driveway of Celina's home, with Father Craig Cheney leading the family, friends, and neighbors in prayer and offering comfort.
Yeah, tonight is a community surrounded by light. I'd like to start this little vigil service off by raising your candles in the air, everyone together. Remind us that this candlelight can be a beacon of light, a beacon of hope for those who are missing in our midst. It's an amazing thing how small communities can band together. And we know that people are working very hard to find our sister and bring her home.
I once was lost, but now I am found. Was blind, but now I see.
In the latest developments, a press conference was held near the missing girl's home in which officials discussed where the case presently stands.
Earlier today, the FBI joined the investigation into the disappearance of Ms. Cass. They have joined the state police in trying to locate her. Kieran Ramsey from the FBI is here. I'll let him provide more detail.
We are asking for the public's help and the media's help to safely locate and bring home Celina Cass. Right now, we believe that the media and the public are law enforcement's best ally in this effort, and we ask the people of New Hampshire and the surrounding states to remain vigilant and assist us to bring home Celina Cass safely.
And we're asking that you show this to the public and ask if anybody has seen her or had any contact with her, whether it be telephonically or on the computer, through any of the social working network sites or any of the virtual online worlds, that they contact the state police. Thank you. Have a good evening.
Another candlelight vigil was held, which brought together family, friends, and others concerned about the whereabouts of young Celina. The vigil was held in the town park in West Stewartstown. Among those who were being consoled was Celina's mother, Louisa Noyes. The case, which has been baffling local authorities, received national attention on cable news and was the subject of the entire Nancy Grace program on HLN. The program, which was guest hosted by Diane Diamond, featured video from the Colebrook Chronicle and included this editor, Charles Jordan.
I think, Diane, what's happened here is they've kind of shifted gears a little bit. They're continuing on with the search.
The program aired live at 8 p.m. on Wednesday and was repeated at 1 a.m. on Thursday. Anyone with information are asked to call New Hampshire State Police at 603-846-3333. The U.S. Postal Service has listed 3,700 branches nationwide that might be closed because of revenue losses. One of those on the list is in Beecher Falls, Vermont, housed in the former Order of the Redmen building. Postmaster General Patrick Donahoe, in announcing the planned cuts nationwide, said that customers' habits have made it no longer necessary to have a physical post office in many locations to conduct most of their business, citing increased use of the internet and email.
On Tuesday, about 6 p.m., a swath of high wind ripped through portions of downtown Colebrook, taking down many large trees. On Wednesday, the cleanup was underway. The home of Fred and Betty King on Cross Street miraculously escaped serious damage as two large trees on either side of their home were blown down. Damage could be seen at residences along Bridge Street. On Main Street, trees came down around Jenkins' funeral home. The Weather Vane Theater's Patchwork Players came to the Tillotson Center on Tuesday for a lively rendition of Rumpelstiltskin. The children's show was hosted by the Colebrook Rec Department and sponsored by the Colebrook Chronicle. It was the first major outside theater performance to be brought to the center's stage.
Share your ideas.
Kimberly Holmes and Cheryl Fitzpatrick are the Canadian duo who call themselves the B-flat Sisters. Both play the fiddle and the keyboard, and this week they arrived in Colebrook on their first tour, accompanied by Kimberly's husband, Skip. Their appearance on Monday was sponsored by the Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts and is the latest in the GNWCA's partnership with the Sky Theatre of Maine to bring Celtic performers to our region. The B-flat Sisters specialize in old-timey and French-Canadian tunes, and they drew a crowd of about 100 to the Colebrook Country Club. It was there that we talked with them about their music.
I grew up listening to Winston Scotty Fitzgerald, the famous Cape Breton fiddler, and I tried to chord in that Cape Breton piano style, but I also love the French-Canadian piano accompaniment style.
The secret to trying to play the style the best you can is to listen to it and to, you've got to engross yourself in that music. So listening's a big part of it. And, you know, we met in 2002, but we have similar upbringing where our parents listened to the music. There was always records being played at home.
Well, see, I grew up playing rock and roll and blues, and Mom listened to big bands, so I got that influence. And then for probably till I was in my 20s, I never listened to the fiddle.
Really? Yeah.
But then I saw the light. I listen to Celtic players, you know, I listen to jazz players, I listen to rock, blues players, and I sort of try to incorporate all that into backup, which is really what I love doing, is backing up.
Like, we have our own set of tunes that we play individually on the fiddle. Like, she has a lot of fiddle tunes that I wouldn't even attempt to play, so I accompany her when she's playing those tunes, and they're tunes that we found that we play together, and we've composed harmonies for them, so that's where Skip comes in to back us both up.
I just play tunes that I really like to play that are fun, and whether they're Cape Breton, old time, or French Canadian, or Irish, it really depends on the tunes.
This is our first major tour, the B-flat Sisters.
After this, we're playing in Rangeley, and then Sky Theatre, and then Unity Center, and then off to Portland to do two shows with Randy Labby and in connection with the Saltwater Celtic Festival.
We all listen to different types of music, you know, and it's and I'm always sort of thinking, okay, well, what could I do, you know, in my playing that, just to make my backup more interesting.
One of the most important things is that we were brought up on this music, so it's in our blood.
It's part of me. It's who I am. I have to play. Like, it's just part of who I am.
Thank you.
Prepare for a chance of thunderstorms tonight with a high of 75 and a low of 59. Rain will continue into Saturday with a high of 78 and a low of 52. Sunday, expect skies to clear up with a high of 79 and a low of 56. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.